नमस्कारम भगवत गीता सेकंड चैप्टर इन 54th श्लोका अर्जुन आस्क्ड कृष्णा अबाउट स्थित प्रज्ञा वन हु इज स्टडी माइंडर ही आस्क्ड अबाउट हाउ डस ही वॉक हाउ डस ही सिट हाउ डस ही टॉक नाउ फ्रॉम 55th श्लोका लॉर्ड कृष्णा आंसर्स अर्जुन सो इन 55th श्लोका लॉर्ड सेज ओ पार्थ The one who has got no desires, no craving for senses, is satisfied in realization of self. And such a person is said to be transcendentally situated. So here he explains how craving for senses affect mind. If you are away from materials, your mind remains calm. There is no disturbance and there is no distraction and he realizes the divinity of Atma. He realizes Atma and he realizes Atma is divine. Atma is divine because it is a fragment of Paramatma. Paramatma created and Paramatma is maintaining that. So it is divine. If you are ignorant, then you will not understand this. Those who are ignorant about this concept, they feel they are body. Such a person says, I am the body. So he goes after the materials. And he goes for searching material in this world, which is a lust. So he explains very clearly the characteristics of sthita prajnan. This is like, when you go after materials and if you don't get material, you are not fully happy because you want more and more. You are comparing yourself with others and you are in search of some more material. So you are not understanding that Atma is happy always. So there is happiness within ourselves. We don't realize that because that material energy, Maya, creates an illusion of happiness. We think that we derive happiness from materials and we don't reach it at all. We don't get happiness because we keep on adding our desires. So this is like in deserts, how animals go after the mirage. So they think that there is a water, but they do not understand that it is an illusion of water. But out of because they feel thirsty, they move towards water, and by that, because they keep moving, because there is no water actually, so they get exhausted too. So this is how happiness is. So it is an illusion, and we should understand that our soul remains happy always. So happiness is within ourselves. So one who realizes this, he will be free from the birth and death. And one who goes in this path eliminates the selfish desires from his heart. So this is very well explained by Lord Krishna in this sloka. Then he explains more in the next sloka, the different stages. So the one who has got the wisdom, that is talking about the wise people, the steady minded people, they give up craving for pleasure. They remain free from fear and they devoid of anger. They are enlightened persons who do not have lust, anger, greed, envy and so on. And they are in transcendentally position. If you are drawn towards material, there is no contemplation of divinity. There is no contemplation of happiness within ourselves. So we search it outside and we lament over miseries. These people, these jnanis, do not do that. because there is no craving for pleasure. How nice it would be. It is very much applicable for us, because we get attracted by so many things, all new toys and new gadgets and new equipments. So we always have a craving for getting what all come to the market. So if we don't get it, we get disappointed. So here they give up that craving for pleasure. So they remain free from all sorts of disappointment, frustration, everything. And they remain free from fear because they do not think of future. Whereas we are after material, so what do? We think of what all happened in the past. Why I didn't get that? I was without that. So we keep talking about that. And we are losing happiness in the present time. And we think of future. No, I have to keep all this. I have to multiply the amount I have for future. I have to buy more houses. I have to buy more vehicles for future. So we think of future and we, will I get it? Will I make it? Will I save? So we, our mind goes that way. So there is a fear. If I don't get, if I am not able to save so much, if I don't get so much of income after my retirement, so what happens? You are not enjoying the pleasure, you are not enjoying the happiness. Happiness is within ourselves. So we are losing everything. So this jnanis are away from that. Then devoid of anger, there is no disappointment, there is no greediness, so there is no frustration. So naturally there is no anger. So these people, so Lord Krishna describes the how these people are, because Arjuna asked him. So he refers them as enlightened persons. And these people, these jnanis, are not for getting the pleasures. That is, they do not hanker for pleasures. And they do not lament over miseries. So they are happy with themselves. So they are happy because they realize this soul, they have that Atma Jnanam. So their mind is without anger, greediness, then lust, envy, and all these negative attitudes. In next sloka, Lord Krishna says they are unattached under all conditions, in whichever situation they are in. They are not attached to that. Neither they are dejected by tribulations, nor delighted by good fortune. So they do not celebrate if anything they accumulate. There is no question of accumulating as far as they are concerned. Even if they get, they do not celebrate it. Because that doesn't, they know the materials do not bring happiness to them. Even if they lose it, if they don't have it, they do not feel sad about it. So they are away from this maya. If we feel that materials give happiness, then we are under maya. So there is no attachment to anything. For example, in office, if you are given any assignment, if we are not appreciated, then we get upset. So, don't expect appreciation. You are doing honestly because you have that duty conscious mind. So, you are doing it. You are sincere. You are honest to yourself. And you are not getting attached. So, what is meant by getting attached to the job or anything? That you think that I am the one who is doing. If I am not there, this work would not have been completed. That sort of, I am the person who made this job very well. So these kinds of thoughts should not be there. So no I. So when you think like that, there is no appreciation, you feel upset. So all these messages are given to us to lead a very peaceful life. by Krishna. Krishna's advice benefited not only Arjuna. The advice, the message, what we take from Bhagavad Gita benefiting us more, because we come across so many challenges every day, and we have a very wavering mind. Sometimes we don't know how to handle the situation. The problem is we are attached to that. So we get different moods. So we get angry, we get greediness. So all sort of unwanted qualities get into us. So once we remove all that, we do not get attracted to material. So we know what is real, what is permanent, what is eternal. Then we realize Atma, we realize Soul. So this is what Krishna talks about, Sthita Prajnan. Because he is steady, there is no wavering in his mind. Because he has understood the concept, so he is going ahead with that. So nothing attracts him. So it's a beautiful message for us.